For me, TIMES is very interactive, whereby lecturers become facilitators. We create activities and resources in a sequential mode to guide students towards the learning objective of your own module.
It's like it's very much ease of access. It's like students can just go on TIMES, click on the subject, and they'll see, oh, this is what I need to do. Oh, this is what I need to watch.
Basically functions like a one-stop center for all the lecturers' resources and materials.
The lecturers will basically just share most of the things, for example, lecture slides, into TIMES.
It's so great to use TIMES because I saw the potential of TIMES. Initially, I didn't quite understand how to use it, but when I got learning to use it, when I really understood how it worked, I think it's a perfect tool for teaching.
So far, I find TIMES quite good. For example, lecturers are able to communicate to students, like making last-minute announcements, cancellation of classes, because TIMES support is a place where students actually log on to every day. Therefore, information are able to be transferred quite fast as well. Therefore, I find TIMES very good.
There's a lot of tools that's very important for all the students in TIMES alone. Okay, for example, online quizzes, they can actually do their quiz in their homes, in the classrooms.
We have actually done quizzes online, right, in company with our friends as well. And sometimes the quizzes, it allows us to, you know, access this quiz very conveniently instead of sitting in an exam hall and, you know, cramping and getting stressed up. But we could do these quizzes in an open manner. A textbook around with our friends to discuss and also even to look up some good answers on Google as well.
I could also embed quizzes in any one of those weeks, and what's great about it is it's all happening online and they could access TIMES wherever they are.
It can also be a point for the students to actually revise for their lessons before the final exams. I usually post up a question, a reflective question about a lesson that they have learned, and their answers will reflect and summarize their understanding about it.
Besides quizzes, we also have forums. So similarly, instead of conducting our tutorials in classrooms, we had to study at home and then choose our preferable environment. And from there, we can easily check our feedbacks and sometimes answers from our other friends.
Another function that I really like is the forum function, which allows me to post up individual topics and allow the students to engage in online discussion, which I also sometimes do in class as well through the TIMES module. They basically submit, they do the group discussion in the class, and they submit their responses through the forum.
My lecturer uses the forum section, so we have a very active discussion there. So the lecturer will ask a question and then we give answer, and then she will actually check our answer to elaborate more on it.
Forums is also another one of my regular activities that I post up for my students. One thing, because we can actually use forums for a simple discussion. We can also use forums to actually do an exercise based on the lesson of the week.
I'm actually use TIMES as a criteria for referencing. I mean, they have to log into TIMES. They have to get something out of TIMES in order to understand what they have to do.
I actually utilizing some messages. So if I have some announcement, I have some notes that I want to send to them, they actually can send to the particular individual or else a whole group of tutorial session.
Other than doing a forum, they can also sketch out their understanding and their learning process by trying out apps such as Padlet, Poplet and Wordle. This is my students' favorite external apps that they love it when I integrate it in TIMES. So they have a wholesome experience of not just the TIMES portal itself, but also being able to relate TIMES with these external apps and how they work together.
Because you could actually put videos there, you can embed YouTube, you can embed... I'm using a really great social media site called Juta, and I'm actually working with these developers here. And I actually successfully embed Juta cards here, and these are great referencing tools for learning. So I actually put Juta cards on TIMES, and they were able to look at it. So I could put that on a weekly basis, and I don't really need to type too many things on the front on the actual categories, but I can actually put links to the notes, and the links to the notes can also have links to the videos.